एवरीवन, वेलकम टू टेस्का टेक्नोलॉजीज प्राइवेट लिमिटेड। माय नेम इज आशिम दत्ता एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट लेजर फाइबर ऑप्टिक ट्रेनर एंड इट्स ऑर्डर कोड इज 28507। सो इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट इट्स वर्किंग। सो दिस इज द लेजर डायोड मॉड्यूलेशन ट्रांसमीटर यूनिट एंड दिस इज द लेजर डायोड डीमॉड्यूलेशन रिसीवर यूनिट। सो इन दिस द लेजर डायोड मॉड्यूलेशन ट्रांसमीटर यूनिट देयर इज अ सेट पीओ पोर्ट। Then this is the VIN port, this is the ground port, this is the VO port, this is the VM port, and this is the switch for switching to APC and ACC mode. Then this is the FO PT port, here you can see that, and this is the FO pin port, here you can see that, and this is the fiber optic cable which is connected between transmitter unit and receiver unit. Then this is the set RN port, this is the VO port, this is the ground port, this is the PO1 port, this is the PO2 port, and this is the adapter supply port, and this is also the adapter supply port. Now we are going to perform an experiment on the kit. So the experiment we are going to perform is to study the optical power output PO versus laser diode forward current. So for that we have to do the connections first. So firstly we will connect this fiber optic cable with the transmitter unit and the receiver unit. So one of the end will be connected at the transmitter unit laser output port. So this is the port where we will connect the one end of fiber optic cable, and the other end will be connected at the receiver unit FO pin port like this. So that is how we will connect this fiber optic cable between transmitter unit and receiver unit. Now we will connect this adapter cable at the adapter port. Like this. Now we will connect both the voltmeter across the transmitter unit and the receiver unit. So this multimeter will be connected to the transmitter unit, so we will connect the negative to the ground and we will connect the positive to the VO port. And first we have to keep this set PO port at fully anti-clockwise direction. And now we will connect the another multimeter, so we will connect the negative to the PO2 port and we will connect the positive to the PO1 port like this. So that is how the connection is done. Now we will switch on the adapter supply and now we will switch on the multimeter. So here on the multimeter you can see that at the transmitter unit voltage is 0 and at the receiver unit the voltage is -0.792 volt. So this is the voltage which is coming across PO1 and PO2. Now we will slowly increase the transmitter unit voltage by using this set PO port. So here on the multimeter you can see the change in the voltage. So when you rotate it in clockwise direction you can see the changes in the voltage. So as you increase the voltage there will be variations in this PO1 and PO2 output voltage. So we will rotate this port in clockwise direction. So we will take a reading at 0.1 volt. So here on the transmitter unit voltage output we can see that here the voltage is 0.1 volt and here on the receiver unit voltage we are getting -0.7 volt approx. And now we will take another reading. So let's take a reading at 0.200 volt. So let's keep it at 0.200 volt by using this set PO port. You can vary the voltage. So here I have set this transmitter unit voltage as 0.202 volt and at the receiver unit voltage we are getting -0.556 volt. So this is the voltage which is coming across PO1 and PO2. So So that is how you can take different readings and you can form the table which is present in the manual. So that is how you can perform this experiment. Now we are going to perform another experiment, that is to study automatic current control ACC or automatic power control APC modes of operation. So for that we have to do the connections first. So the connections will be remain same as the earlier experiment. Now firstly we will connect this multimeter at the ground and VO port, and we will keep this switch at ACC mode. Then in the receiver unit we will connect this multimeter across PO1 and PO2, and we will keep this rotator potentiometer at fully anticlockwise position. Now we will connect the adapter at the adapter ports and we will switch on the multimeters. So at 0 volt, as you can see that here the voltage is 0 because we have keep this set PO port at fully anticlockwise position. Now we will take readings for ACC and APC. So firstly we will keep this switch at ACC. So by using this switch you can switch to ACC and APC. So first we will keep it at ACC, and now we have keep this set PO position firstly at 0 volt. Here you can see that. Now we will slowly increase the voltage by rotating this set PO port in clockwise direction. So now here you can see the change in the voltage across PO1 and PO2 when we increase the voltage here. So let's keep it at 0.150 volt. Like this. So here you can see the voltage reading. So that is how you can take the different readings for ACC. Similarly you can do it for APC. So we have to switch for APC, and we will connect this positive terminal of this multimeter to the VM port like this. So this is the VM port. We have connected the positive terminal of this multimeter here, and you can see the changes in the readings. So at 0.151 volt here -0.313 volt is showing, but at ACC we are getting -0.6 volt at the PO1 and PO2 output. So that is how you can take different readings of ACC and APC, and you can form the table which is shown in the manual. So that is how you can perform this experiment. Now we are going to perform another experiment, that is to design an evaluation of an laser diode analog IM system. So for that we have to do the connections first. So firstly we will connect this fiber optic cable between transmitter unit and receiver unit, and one end is connected to the transmitter unit laser point and the other end is connected to the receiver unit FOPT point. Now we will do the further connections. Now for this experiment we have to connect this receiver unit fiber optic cable to the FO pin port. So that is how we will connect this fiber optic cable at FO pin point like this. Now we will connect this multimeter across PO1 and PO2 port like this. So the positive will be connected to the PO1 and the negative will be connected to the PO2. So that is how the multimeter is connected across PO1 and PO2. The positive is connected to the PO1 and the negative is connected to the PO2. Now, on the transmitter unit, we will connect this function generator. So we will connect the positive at the Vin port and we will connect the ground to the negative port like this. And now we will connect this DSO across receiver unit. So we will connect the positive at the Vout and we will connect the negative to the ground like this. So that is how the connection is done. Now we will switch on the function generator and we will switch on the DSO. We have to connect the adapters of transmitter unit and receiver unit at the adapter port. So now here we have to set sine frequency at 2 kilohertz like this. And now we will set amplitude at 2 VPP. Now we will remove this fiber cable pin from FO pin port. And now we will connect it to FOPT port like this. And now by using this set RN port, we will adjust this waveform . So that is how you can adjust the waveform pattern by using this set RN port like this. So by using this set PO port, we can also adjust the waveform and we can get the Vin and VO values from the function generator and the DSO, and you can plot the table between Vin and VO, and that is how you can perform this experiment. You can also switch to APC and ACC mode. So these are the different modes on which you can take the readings of Vin and VO, and you can plot the table between Vin and VO. And that is how you can perform this experiment. Now we are going to perform another experiment, that is to design an evaluation of laser diode digital transmission system. So for that, the connections will be remain same as the earlier one, just we have to again switch on the function generator and we have to switch on the DSO. Otherwise, the connection is same. Now, here we have to go for the square wave. So here we have to set square wave frequency at 10 kilohertz. So here on the DSO you can observe that there is a square wave. Now we have to set the square wave amplitude at 2 VPP. Now we will keep this switch at APC mode first, and now we will use this set RN port and we can check the rise and fall time. Similarly, we can do it for ACC. So here also we can check the rise and fall time for ACC and APC. So that is how you can perform this experiment, and you can observe the waveform in the manual also. So that's all the demonstration from my side. If you have any query related to this kit, you can contact at Tesca Global website. You can find the link in the description. For more information, go through the manual. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, like, share and subscribe to our channel.